setting, clinic. You are speaking with a patient who has recently involved in a traffic accident and suffered a head injury. Today the doctor has diagnosed him with post-traumatic epilepsy and advised him to take medication to help prevent further attacks. 1. Explain about epilepsy and reassure him. 2. Answer the patient's questions and reassure him regarding the safety of the prescribed medication. 3. Explain that because it is usual to continue medication until there have been no seizures for at least 4 years, it is possible for a lifelong course of medication. 4. Explain that the headaches and blackouts can be effectively and safely controlled by the medication and enable a person to lead a normal lifestyle. 5. Reassure a patient that his travel plans will not be affected by medication. 7. Offer him some literature about epilepsy and support services available. Here the setting is clinic. You are talking to a patient who is anxious due to his condition. He has been diagnosed with epilepsy. So here you can start your conversation by saying, "Good morning. Please be seated. My name is Sarah. I am the registered nurse in this clinic." Then you can ask like, "You seem to me quite upset. Is there anything bothering you?" Probably the patient may tell you the reason. He may tell you like, "Nurse, I have consulted the doctor with some unusual tiredness. And he diagnosed me with post-traumatic epilepsy. I am really worried and unsure about my situation." Then we need to reassure the patient. So you can tell him like, "Don't worry, I will explain everything in detail. Before proceeding further, I would like to know your name, please." Here let's assume the name is Mr. John. Then you can explain what is epilepsy. Here you can say like, "Epilepsy is the disruption of electrical activities in the brain. Whereas post-traumatic epilepsy is a form of acquired epilepsy that results from brain damage caused by physical trauma to the brain. For my better understanding of your condition, shall I ask you a few questions?" Then you can ask question like, "Do you have a history of fall or accidental injury to your head?" Probably he may tell you like, "Ah, yes, I have met with a road traffic accident when the year before, and I suffered from a head injury." Then you can tell like, "Mr. John, I am so sorry to hear that you met with an accident. You know, Mr. John, your present condition is due to the head injury resulted from their road accident. Sometimes patient may not agree with you." Then you can tell him like, "Mr. John, I realize your anxiety. Definitely, I will help you to sort it out, but before moving further, would it be okay if I can ask you some questions?" Then you can ask questions like, "Do you experience any sort of disturbance or physical illness after the accident? Have you ever experienced headache? Are there, than this, anything else you have been feeling since the accident?" These questions you can ask one by one. Then we can explain about treatment. So you can tell him like, "This condition has a very definitive treatment plan, okay?" Probably patient may ask you questions like, "How long I need to continue these medications and what are the side effects?" Then you can reply like, "Mr. John, I am glad to explain it to you. The medications for epilepsy are usually continued until there have been no seizures for at least 4 years, and sometimes it is necessary to continue the medications for a lifelong. These medications are the best possible solution for relieving your symptoms such as headaches, blackouts and tiredness. Also, it will enable you to lead a normal life." Sometimes patient may ask you about the side effects. Then you can tell him like, "All right, Mr. John, the side effects as you suspect are really rare. And if you find any kind of side effects, kindly report them to the doctor. Definitely the doctor will change the medication accordingly." Then patient may ask about travel restrictions. Then we can answer like, "Your concern is really understandable. But don't worry, none of the medications prescribed to you will affect your travel. You will be able to travel to any country as you desire. The only thing you need to consider is not to skip the medications while you are on a trip." Then, as per ask, we can give some additional information like, "Mr. John, There is an Epilepsy Foundation available. They can provide you more details regarding the disease and its management at home. If you are interested, I could provide you with their contact details. And I can also fix an appointment for you. In addition, I could also supply you with some of the literature that helps you to know more about post-traumatic epilepsy. Is that okay? Then, we can wind up by saying, do you have any other concerns that I need to be answered? If there is no concern, you can tell like, I hope I have cleared all your doubts. If you have any other doubts, kindly don't hesitate to contact me. We are here to help you. Thank you, Mr. John. I wish you a very speedy recovery. That is the end of your story.